上面都不要。
小
月，
你打电话了呀？
嗯，忙不着。
得一百分多钱。
你说，哎，这领子啊？
这领子要得一百嘞。
我这领子啊，你好像有在线。好像结婚以后，不行，可以好。好三千就来一次，然后导演我都跟修没时间，我都睡在那边打。
哦，我都听
下歌。我 speaking 那个好歌呀，所以净系可以听那个。
喂，佢通常冇得播出 voice 嘅。
佢唔系 multiple choice。
系乜嘢？
其实你呢度有成千几个字噶嘛，佢会抽70个出嚟，你就俾英文你写中文。
哦 ，OK OK。
跟住之后病嗰度有成都70个噶嘛，佢就抽5个，你就要写。
中文
英文但是要
explain the symptoms
不用 explain 但是你要寫三個 symptoms
OK
兩個不記得中文
symptoms
你知道他那裡有句話你寫曬那句話就算了你知道 total 零
個 point 然後
之後FX 那裡就
in the heart There's an artery that's called the left pulmonary artery. But there isn't one called the right pulmonary artery. So have you explained why?
You just don't see it there. It has to go on the back going into. See, this goes here. There's another part missing on the back.
And once we start dissecting the organ, the amount of words that we use is not even touched in there. But these are words that you're not going to be using because it's more like for people who study the actual body and need to know how the body functions in order to treat it. So, but this is your information that you would be using as a medical interpreter. All right, guys. So we're gonna we talked about how the heart works, how the lungs work. We need to talk about how the brain works because what makes your heart and your lungs work is your brain. The brain runs the show. If something's wrong with your brain, nothing works. So in every organ is important because every organ has a job to do in the body. The body has sort of a domino effect. So if one thing's not working right, another is not, and it goes down. That's why when someone gets sick with one thing, and they don't get fixed, they don't get healed fast enough, another organ starts acting out because it's a domino effect. So everything has to work in a function that everything has to be working level, in a perfect harmony. And if the body's not in harmony, the body doesn't work right. So. The system, the heart, the body, the nervous system is composed of the brain and the spinal cord. And if I don't give you a diagram, the diagrams that I'm going to be giving you, I want you to concentrate and study them. I'm not going to give you a diagram of every single system around, because I don't want you to concentrate on stuff that may not be in the text, okay? But I do want you to learn about it so that you sort of understand when they're talking to you. What is it that they're talking about? So, The nervous system is composed of the brain, so the brain is the one who controls everything. You have the spinal cord. Now, in the spinal cord, you have the nerves that go through every single part of the body. So, here, your spinal cord, like it is there, this is the back now, that's the front. So the spinal cord goes all the way down. And in the spinal cord, all these nerves come out to control different parts of your body. When you have a pain, this is how orthopedics and neurologists work. Let's say you have a pain in your leg. Sciatica is very common. A lot of people have sciatic pain. And the sciatic pain is a nerve that we have right about here and right there. And this nerve gives you pain that goes right to your butt here, and then it can shoot down the back of your leg. Now, we know that sciatic pain because that's exactly how it works. Occasionally, somebody comes in with similar pain, but then the pain shoots and hurts this way. Now we know it's another nerve. It's another nerve that goes, see the nerves down here, the lumbar nerve. There's a nerve in the lumbar area, depending on how high and how low it is, that is damaged, is pinched, is inflamed, that is given pain in a different area. So this is how we know in neurology when you have a damaged nerve or pinched nerve, depending on how the pain is. How numb is it? Is it numb? Is it tingling? Remember those vocabulary words. Is it numb? Is it tingling? Does it burn? Is it shooting? Is it stabbing? Because all that has to do with the nerves. Yes?
So sciatica, right?
Sciatica?
Sciatica. It's cause of a damaged nerve?
Sciatica normally is an inflamed nerve.
Inflamed nerve.
Yeah. So usually what works for something like that is exercise, physical therapy, ibuprofen, around the clock. Like three times a day, just back to it for around 2-3 weeks. Plus, there's another exercise that they do for sciatica, which is tightening your butt muscles. When you tighten up your butt muscles, you build up the muscle enough that lets go of the nerve that is pinching. So a lot of those exercises are things that we do. We have cranial nerves, so those are the nerves they go from your brain to your eyes, nose, ears, and other parts of your head. You have central nerves that are in your brain and spinal cord. So the central, meaning this is the boss, okay? This is what runs the show. We have peripheral nerves. These are the nerves that go from your spinal cord to your arms, your legs, and your feet. Those are the ones that you feel the pain, the burning, the throbbing, all that kind of stuff. When you hurt, you have that throbbing pain, but you hurt your arm. Those are your peripheral nerves. Also, your peripheral nerves are the ones that tell you when it's cold and when it's hot. So when you get caught, right away, your pores start opening up and sends a message to your brain that is hot. So you start sweating to cool off your body. Because if it is hot outside, we're 98.6 inside. If we're 90 outside, now we're gonna go to 100 and something. So if we don't start sweating and cooling off, we could end up in shock. So that's the body's way of knowing how to do it. Now, when it's cold, this is when it's very cold, you have that, ooh, when you're cold. So now it's telling the brain to warm up. Build up your steam in there because it's cold. That's when your arms, the hair starts sticking up. Those are part of your sensory nerves. So the sensory nerves, the ones that feel in the outside, those are the ones that tell the brain what to do when it's hot, when it's cold, when it's lukewarm, all these things. We also have autonomic, not automatic, but autonomic nerves. They go from your spinal cord to your lungs. So these are the ones that run your lungs, the stomach, the heart, things that we cannot control. We cannot control the heart. We cannot control your stomach. And when it's doing digestion and all that, we can't stop it. It's all automatic. We cannot control your intestines. They work all on themselves. The bladder. We cannot tell the bladder, don't fill up with urine. Sex organs. The sex organs, the ovary, the testicles, all that gets developed and they work all on their own. We can't control them. We can't stop them unless we're in infertility treatment and we give you injections to stop them or to make them work harder. So these are all the nerves. These nerves are extremely important, the autonomic nerves. They run your lungs, heart, everything. So we cannot control those.
Can we move?
Excuse me.
Yes.
Can you spell the ones on the left, the bottom left? I can see them.
The peripheral nerves? Peripheral. Yeah, that control, those are the ones that control the spinal cord, the arms, hands, legs, and feet. Those are the ones that get damaged with diabetics. Most diabetics, if their diabetes is out of control, this is what they have. They have pins and needles on their feet, or the feet and the hands go numb. It's because the peripheral nerves get damaged by the sugar. The sugar has done damage already to them. And we cannot get it back. Once we're damaged, we can't get it back. All body systems are controlled and regulated through the nervous system. The central part, remember, the one that controls the brain and the spinal cord. And the second part is the outer part made up of the nerves that are connect the brain to all areas of the body. So that's what the nervous system is composed of. So we just mentioned this earlier, just a few minutes ago. So the nervous system works both automatically and under direct control. So automatic control means autonomic control. It's breathing, heart rate, and digestion, right? Now, we cannot control those. Those are totally automatic. Direct control functions are walking, running, talking, any of these things. You can stop, you can start, you can control these. Because you're telling the brain you want to walk, so you walk. You're telling the brain we're talking, we just talk. We don't even think we're telling these things to the brain. It's totally automatic. So those are under direct control. We direct the control. We run that show. But the other one, we have no control over. How does it work? The nervous system is made up of more than 86 billion neurons.
That's a lot.
Quite a bit. Each with thousands of connections. Now, each one of them has thousands of connections. Out of those billions, okay? The nerve cells are able to organize and conduct messages in the form of small electrical impulses. We call those nerve impulses. So the brain talks to the body by electricity. The heart works by electricity. So all these things run by electricity. Motor nerves pass messages from the brain to the spinal cord, to the part of the body, like lifting my hand. These are my nerves. Sensory nerves are the ones that we talked about outside. Those are the ones that they pick up messages from the outside. These are also the ones that, these are sensory nerves, the ones we smell. Now, our brain remembers everything. Our brain has a filing system. Odors are already, any odor you have been exposed to in your entire life is filed away. The minute that you smell that odor again, your brain will remember.
Yeah. Grandma's food.